And he just spoiled the freaking end of the documentary. So if you guys were planning to go and see it, you now know the end. Well done, Dave, spoiling your own documentary. Check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys. Hello, how's it going, everybody? Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, hello, my name is Cam, and if you're not new, you keep coming back again and again, thank you. I really appreciate you. Today's video is brought to you by my Patreon supporters. Thank you so much for your support, you guys. I really appreciate it. Patreon is a platform where I post more personal kind of videos, so if you're interested in that kind of stuff, there's a link in the description bar below, and with that, let's get into the video. So today we're talking about Built Through Courage by Dave Hollis yet again, but this time it's a documentary, because Built Through Courage and Dave Hollis, my friends, they are the gifts that keep on giving. So basically, as you guys know, Dave Hollis, Rachel Hollis's ex-husband, the ex-Disney executive who then quit his job at Disney to become a motivational speaker for a women's company, for Rachel's company, that she spent like more than a decade building up. He just decided to take over the company from her and become the CEO. That guy, he just came up with a book called Built Through Courage, and I have reviewed it, so I'm going to link it up above here if you're interested in an in-depth review of the book. I was going to say the documentary, but that tongue slip there was because there was also going to be a documentary called Built Through Courage about Dave Hollis's journey of, I don't know, like living in privilege your entire life and then considering that you made it. I'm not really sure what the documentary is going to be about, but it's called Built Through Courage, so I'm assuming it would have some sort of common ground with the book. This documentary was meant to come out on the 17th of November in theaters in America, and I was planning to see it. I'm in Romania, so it would not be possible for me to see it in theaters in America, clearly. I mean, Dave is not really worth me traveling all that way for just the one film. But basically, Kia from Kia's World End, you guys should hold on until the end because I have an announcement. Something really exciting is happening. Anyways, so Kia told me in the comments of my previous video on Dave Hollis that basically, if you buy a ticket to the documentary in a theater, you also get online access. So I was planning to see it and review it. Well, I guess Dave Hollis has made my job easier because, as it turns out, this documentary showing has been canceled. Built Through Courage, the documentary, was sort of organized by this company called Fathom Events. And basically, right now, when you go on the theater's webpage, it shows as cancelled. Not only that, but people who bought tickets to see the movie have received the cancellation email, and somebody posted it on Reddit. And the cancellation email says, "Dear valued guest, we are reaching out to let you know that your tickets to see Dave Hollis Built Through Courage on November 17th have been refunded. Fathom has cancelled the event due to low performance. We apologize for any inconvenience this show cancellation has caused. Please note, if you paid with a credit card, you can expect to see the refund back into your account within 5 to 7 business days. If you paid with movie club credits, your credits have not been added back to your account. If you paid with a gift card, your funds are now available on the gift card they used initially. We hope to see you back at the movies again soon. Please feel free to contact us, etc., etc." Clearly, as it shows from this email, the event was cancelled by Fathom, by the event organizer, because of low performance. But we have a little situation here because Dave Hollis is lying about the reasons on his Instagram Live. As you guys know, he's doing like a book club, reading like a chapter of his book every day or something of the sort. That's not quite what a book club is in the first place, but let's not go there right now. We'll go there some other time. He's reading to people. That's not what a book club is. Anyways, in yesterday's book club video on Instagram, he announced the fact that the movie was going to be postponed, the documentary. But he basically talked about it being a boundary, and it's just going to be postponed to the beginning of the year. That is really, really soon. I really don't think so, because if it was going to be postponed at the beginning of the year, they would have a date by now. So, I mean, we are like almost mid-November. There is no, like, normally these things are scheduled in advance. It's not like at the last minute. But he's sort of lying, and there's like a few very interesting things he says. There's like maybe a 5-minute clip or something. I'm gonna play it for you, and I'm gonna stop to commentate on a few of these things. It's only a 3-minute clip, which is great because it means that he's not rambling on and on forever about it. But still, I think this clip is very telling of a few things. So let's listen.
There's also, though, had to be a boundary where I had to ask what was the best and most important thing that I could spend time on in real time, to make sure that I'm getting the most out of all of what is happening in my life. And one of the things that I had to make a decision on, hard decision, but I want to make sure that people understand the rationale, I had to have a tough conversation with my friends that were helping put the documentary into theaters. And if you're not familiar, I made this great movie. I'm super biased and thinking it great, but I do believe.
I just don't ever see any trace of modesty coming from this guy.
A bunch of my buddies inside of personal development having conversations about courage. And I had to tell him, look, I don't think that right now is the time that I want to spend telling people to buy tickets to a documentary. And I...
You're no kidding, Dave. This is not the time to tell people to buy tickets to a documentary, considering you just told people, you yelled at your entire audience to buy your book that costs apparently the same amount of money.
Not even for that. Not even just like not want to tell them to buy tickets, but I'm not even sure that the documentary, in the way that it was finished, captures the entire story because the story itself was still being written and it feels like an inauthentic picture.
Let me see if I understand this. He's not sure that documentary captures the entire story, but the documentary was coming out in 7 days. So was he going to put out a documentary that is incomplete, like knowingly? Just literally rip people off, like make them go to see a movie that doesn't have a complete story? Because that's so unethical on so many levels. That being said, this is total bullshit. This is a total excuse. This is completely false because the reason it was canceled is because of low performance. So what is this complete and utter bullshit he's giving us about how the story was not complete? And if the story was not complete, why were you selling it to theaters and why were you about to put out a documentary with an incomplete story?
Hey, this thing's gonna end with me sitting on a rock telling you that if you are able to just conjure the courage to...
And he just spoiled the freaking end of the documentary. If you guys were planning to go and see it, you now know the end. Well done, Dave. Spoiling your own documentary. So you're saying that basically this documentary is going to be postponed to the beginning of 2021 and you already spoiled the ending. I'm assuming not only will you find time from now, the 10th of November, until the beginning of the year to basically remake this documentary or change the ending, I'm assuming, add things to it. That's not an easy thing to do, especially when you have a finished product. And it's not cheap either. But that being said, I'm not really concerned with money when it comes to Dave Hollis. But basically, you're just going to add things to the documentary like at the last minute and then try to sell it to theaters for the beginning of the year. That seems like a very tight window.
Do something that you feel called to, that it finishes with a little nice bow on top. Because my experience was, yeah, you can get there, but also the fear that you have or the self-doubt or imposter syndrome or whatever may in fact be something of a trigger that still presents itself. And I want to try and capture that as well. So I asked them, hey, instead of doing it next...
So he didn't think that the fear and the imposter syndrome and stuff were a problem. Like up until this moment in time, the 10th of November, he thought that was no problem. And that didn't need to be part of a documentary about courage. So when you talk about courage in any way, shape or form, you don't talk about fear, which is really what it takes to be courageous. There's got to be fear there. Like, how can you make a documentary that is 2 hours long about courage without talking about fear and without talking about the imposter syndrome? Like, what is in this movie?
Can we do it closer to the beginning of the year, so that I don't have to pivot into sales mode.
That's what the lie is. So he is, this isn't postponed, this has been canceled. The word they use is canceled. This event has been canceled by the event management company, Fathom Events, and the theater has canceled. They've not said postponed. Now, that being said, of course, you can go back to the theater and try to resell or whatever. But this event is not postponed. This event is canceled. Words mean stuff. Words are important, Dave.
When I am not feeling like being in sales mode on social media right now.
Oh, he doesn't want to be in sales mode? What happened? Because like a few days ago, you were just selling, like really very hardcore, aggressively selling your book. One. And two, didn't you work in sales for Disney for like 2 decades or something? Like, since when is sales a problem for Dave Hollis?
Can I do it at the beginning of the year when I can actually take this documentary and take the time that I now have to have a little bit of what has been the last month's worth of the experience of launching the book and incorporate it in it? So it feels like it's maybe a little more authentic, a look at the good, the bad, the all that comes in.
The good, the bad, and the all. It's the good, the bad, and the ugly, my dude. You don't have to. It's the ugly. There's a lot of ugly, indeed. Like, I would love to see that in the document. If this is indeed postponed, I will watch it. I would love to see it. I would love to review it. And I would love to see the ugly in it. But that being said, I know for a fact that they're not going to be very vulnerable about it.
Having courage. And they said, yeah, I mean, this stinks. I appreciate that this is something that has to happen so late, but we want you to put out the very, very best thing. And frankly, we want you to be excited about talking about it. I mean,
they said, wait, the movie tickets. This is just a plain lie. So he says that they said that they appreciate Dave postponing so late in the game, literally 1 week before it's meant to go out. What a bullshit, what a bunch, like he's trying to make himself look so cool. Like, oh my God, like Dave, they canceled the event because not enough people are showing up to the movie. Not enough people have bought tickets. They have forecasted that not enough people will come see it. And you're trying to make it look like, oh my God, you're so cool and you're just postponing your own movie. Like, what?
The movie tickets are like $18. And I mean, the International Internet Association, IIA, yeah, I mean, they said, look, if you say the number 18 over and over in social media again, it's like Beetlejuice.
The movie tickets are $18. You guys, he also said this is the price of the book. In that 2-hour live on Instagram, the disastrous 2-hour live that he posted, I think he said $18 at least like 1,000 times. I don't know, but he said it a lot.
You'll actually conjure the people who create the YouTube videos and they will come like Beetlejuice into your home.
He's like once again complaining about the YouTubers. I'm assuming he's seen my video. I'm assuming he's seen Kia's videos. I'm assuming he's seen Savvy's videos. Mac Attack is another YouTuber who posted about this. And I'm sure that there's dozens and dozens more, but that's as far as I know. But so what? You don't want us to talk about it, Dave? Well, then don't make a fool of yourself on social media, and we won't. We'll have nothing. I mean, up until now, up until like about a week ago, I haven't talked about Dave Hollis, except for obviously their divorce. I talked about them and their divorce, and mostly Rachel, to be honest, before. But this is the first time I'm just tackling Dave particularly. I should have probably talked about Dave before. But this is really the first time that I've actually really just spoken about him. To be honest, Dave, if you don't do any of these things, we won't talk about you. If you don't put out trash books, if you don't put out trash documentaries, if you don't, you know, shoot yourself in the foot on social media, we will have nothing to talk about.
So I just felt like, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and slide that on down the road. I'm going to make it something that is better. I am going to make sure that when I am ready to talk about it, it's going to... I know, $18 coming out of my mouth doesn't work that well.
Yeah, there's a lot of things that don't work very well coming out of your mouth. Things like,
get a life.
To your four-year-old.
Trust me, I have made this note. So I'm gonna slide it. It doesn't mean it's not gonna come out. It's just gonna come out later. And it's gonna come out updated. It's gonna come out updated. So look forward to that. Okay.
I don't think it's gonna come out, you guys. I just think it won't. We'll have to wait and see. I would love for it to come out. I would watch it. I would review it. But I just don't think it will. So, okay, so he's now plain lying. This is a plain lie. You know what? I just don't understand this. Based on what's happened this far, I would have much more appreciated Dave coming out to say, you know what? I've shot myself in the foot. I apologize. This has caused that my documentary showing was canceled. And now I'm going to take some time to rethink, see if I can make it better, see if I can try to sell it again. Why can't he just be honest about this? Like, this is an interesting part of the process, to be completely honest. I find it fascinating, and I directed and produced documentaries myself. For me, this is fascinating. I want to know, why can't I just get a real, proper, honest story from Dave Hollis on this? I think it would have landed a lot better with his followers too, because now this is all gonna come out. It's gonna blame us, the YouTubers, like the Beatles. But at the end of the day, like, if you just were honest about it, I think this video wouldn't even exist, you know? Maybe I would have talked about documentary being canceled, but I wouldn't have had to say that you're lying. Oh, I'm about to wrap the filming up and start editing. But before I do that, I wanted to say, that I told you at the beginning that there's something exciting. Basically, me and Kia from Kia's World are going to collab. We're going to talk about Dave Hollis's book, because there were a lot of things that I didn't manage to say in my previous video about, in my review, because I actually had so many. I had more than 10 pages of notes. So the video was getting really, really long. So I left a lot of things out. So we're going to talk about the book. We're going to exchange ideas. And we're filming this on Friday, probably coming your way at the weekend. So very excited about that. I can't wait to meet Kia. We have a lot of things in common. We're going to have a little chat, and it's going to be so exciting. Okay, that's it from me for now. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Please let me know what you think in the comments below. Like this video if you like it. Subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you to my patrons, as always, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.
It sound right, boy.